Chapter 162. Dealing with a Dead. 2. The group of Li Xiuyang didn't know what a corpse core was, but Nai Ufen knew a little bit. Legends has it that there were a few invincible existences that wanted to reach the deepest part of the ancient heavenly corpse burial ground. However, their Dao was destroyed and they lost their lives. Some, however, maintained their unharmed bodies and a blood essence. These things spent a countless number of years in the deepest part of the burial ground and finally turned into a thing called a corpse core. It was a very beneficial item to earth corpses, treasure lords, and even earth immortals. The old Taoist sat cross-legged on the ground as a bloody light flashed in his eyes. Then he closed them again. After a long silence, the old Taoist finally took out an item and slowly placed it on the ground. At this time, it was clear to everyone that it was a treasure cauldron, but it was not a heavenly cauldron of the alchemists. It was just a treasure cauldron casted from iron. Even though this cauldron was already returning to its origin, it still emitted strands of green smoke. This was not medicinal fog. Rather, they were powerful strands of steel, resembling a godly sword, that were seemingly able to pierce through the sky. Violet diamond cauldron. One smoke, one sword containing many facets of offense and defense. The old Taoist slowly introduced. Hearing the name Violet Diamond Cauldron, Xiangyang's heart suddenly jumped. He had heard of this name before. It was a cauldron refined by a supreme sect master of the Violet Cloud sect, and it was called the Violet Cloud sect's second defining treasure. But today, it appeared in this place. Deal. Li Kai didn't say much and accept the Violet Diamond Cauldron at once. Then, he casually threw it to Zhang Yu and said, "This cauldron is suitable for you. Figure it out well." Zhang Yu accepted the Violet Diamond Cauldron and was excited. He wanted to open his mouth, but he immediately closed it. Even though there were 10,000 words of appreciation that he could be saying to his oldest brother, this was not the time to talk. The young ones were also envious, but they all knew that as long as they followed their oldest brother, he would not go and mistreat them. The old Taoist put away the heavenly ancient corpse core and slowly took out a sword. It was a sword made out of stone, stone sheath and stone handle. Clang! Li Kai unsheathed the sword and a dragon roar immediately resounded as the sword left its sheath. It was just like a true dragon soaring to the sky. The sword was engraved with tiny layers of dragon scales. The moment it was drawn, the sword scale seemed to have a life of its own and wanted to fly away from the sword. Good sword. Using the Dao bones of a 2,300,000-year-old godly frost dragon to craft, it has the power of the frost dragon as it was refined by an ancient method. It is engraved with a murderous power yet not imprinted with merit law. This means that it still has the potential to be recasted. Li Kai stroked the sword and said, "The frost dragon sword, I crafted this during my prime. The owner will obtain the murderous power of frost and will be able to refine any merit law to it." The old Taoist eventually said slowly, hearing this, everyone's expression couldn't help but change. A 2,300,000-year-old godly frost dragon, even godly kings would lose their colors. Such a powerful heavenly beast turned into a life treasure. How great was this matter? Li Kai opened his treasure box once again to check, and he eventually took out an item like a rock. This item looked like a rock but was actually a fruit. However, it had a cold and stony appearance and was completely black without runes. Just like a rock, an ancient stone fruit, grown in the deepest part of the ancient heavenly corpse lake. It can increase your lifespan from 15 to 20 days. Deal or not? Li Kai placed the stony fruit onto the ground. Nanhuaren's group, and even Xiangyang and Tubuayu, were surprised. They all knew that Li Kai had only obtained these items, but Li Kai's smooth explanation made it sound as if these were his own treasures. This was too incredible. More than very few people knew about the deep locations in the ancient heavenly corpse burial ground, but Li Kai spoke of it clearly like it was his own backyard, and he knew everything with clarity. How was this possible? As for Li Xiuyangyun, she had a similar numbing sensation just like in the past. At this time, no matter what type of miracles Li Kai could concoct, she no longer found it strange. What could be more valuable or more unfathomable than a physique scripture in this world? This ancient item from the immemorial age was never known to have an owner, yet it was in his possession. Thus, Li Xiuyangyun was completely used to Li Kai's scary existence. Only Nai Ufen silently sighed in his heart. From the past till now, it would be difficult to find someone who could be more knowledgeable than young master. Him knowing the ancient heavenly corpse burial ground like the palm of his hand was not enough for him to be astonished. Deal. The old Taoist took the ancient stone fruit without a hint of hesitation and waited for the next round of deals. A godly sword refined with murderous intention. It is most suiting for you. Li Kai nonchalantly threw the frost dragon sword to Tubuayu, and Tubuayu quickly bowed to Li Kai in return after catching the sword. Next, Li Kai immediately took out a small cup inside a treasure box. This small cup was sparklingly clear and was sealed. There was only half a cup of liquid inside. It seemed like a blue ice. With the gentle rocking of the small cup, the blue ice liquid exuded a very bewitching charm. Half a cup of demonic blue spring. You being a treasure lord, I don't need to explain the meaning of the demonic blue spring in the deepest part of the burial ground. Li Kai slowly added, if you have any important treasure, show it to me right now. This is the last chance. Hearing the words demonic blue spring, with bloody lights, the old Taoist's eyes flashed open for a moment. His body trembled once before he closed his eyes again. He remained silent for a long time in his seated position. At this moment, the group all held their breath. Even though they didn't know the reason why this was the last transaction, but seeing Li Kai's serious demeanor, they couldn't help but stare again at the old Taoist ahead. They wanted to see what item he would take out for this trade, deal or not. After a long time, Li Kai rushed this old Taoist. Eventually, the old Taoist austerely took out an item and slowly placed it on the ground. The moment this item was taken out, a golden brilliance, casted by wisps of golden strands like silk, appeared. The most awe-inspiring matter was that this thing resonated very faint immortal vibrations. It was as if they were quiet whispers of immortals. This was an ancient scroll made out of unknown materials. It resembled golden silk and ancient strands. Even though this ancient scroll had suffered countless moons, its golden light was still glittering. A scroll posted from outside the gate of Immortal Dao City. Seeing this item, Li Kai slightly changed his expression as his eyes became serious. He then stared at the old Taoist in front of him and said, "You saw Immortal Dao City?" This question jolted the old Taoist's body. His eyes twitched open and then closed. After a while, he spoke, "In my old age, it was just a little glance, so I wrote down a scroll. Can you say what technique it is?" Li Kai stared at the old man and finally asked in a calm manner, "A scroll of the jagged sword striking immortal technique." The old Taoist answered carefully. After speaking, he closed his eyes and gently sighed with a hint of remembrance along with regret. "You had great yet unfortunate luck. If you were at your peak and saw Immortal Dao City once, then you would have reached a higher level of attainment." Li Kai slightly nodded. He finally took the jagged sword striking immortal technique and threw it over at Zhu Pei. "Make a copy for self-practice, return the original to the sect. Without permission, do not pass it to a second person," Li Kai commanded. Zhu Pei, with matchless excitement, received the scroll and hastily turned towards Li Kai and bowed. She was ecstatic beyond imagination. At the evil-infested ridge, Li Kai rewarded her with a 1,000,000-year-old life ring and now bestowed her with a very precious technique. Since oldest brother treated her so well, she would even endure traversing into the fiery flames just for oldest brother. The old Taoist gathered the demonic blue spring and immediately turned around to step inside the ancient coffin. After a loud roaring sound, the coffin sunk into the ground and a grand formation also disappeared. After the old coffin sank into the earth, Nan Huaren quickly seized this opportunity and anxiously asked, "Oldest brother, why only 3 transactions? A thing should not be attempted more than 3 times. One treasure lore should only be traded with 3 times and one should take turns to show the treasure. If one side does not agree, then the transaction will stop and each will go their separate ways. There are only 9 heavenly ancient corpse treasures inside the heavenly ancient corpse box. At max, I can only deal with 3 treasure lords, and each of them 3 times." Li Kai said, "Heavenly ancient corpse treasures." The group of Ku Daily, one after another, couldn't help but to glance at a box carried by Li Kai on his back. "Heavenly ancient treasure box, heavenly ancient earth messenger adornment, frightened corpse gong." Li Kai patted the clothing worn on his body and raised the gong in his hand, and he said, "Without these 3 items, one cannot become a heavenly ancient earth messenger." "What is a heavenly ancient earth messenger?" Chen Beijiao, next to Li Kai's side, wondered, clang. But, at this moment, Li Kai didn't answer Chen Beijiao's question. He was already knocking on his gong and shouted, "The heavens lasts for ages, and the earth is vast and obscure. Return to the road, return to the bridge. The ancient heavenly earth messenger is here. Gods and devils, along with the earth corpses, all take 3 temples back." Hearing Li Kai's chanting, the group of Li Xuanyin didn't dare to linger and immediately followed right behind Li Kai's back in an orderly fashion as they departed from this valley. They set off once again to find a second treasure lord. They continued to climb the mountains and walk through the rivers. Li Kai went from one Feng Shui treasure earth to another. It was obvious that Li Kai understood the Feng Shui treasure earths inside a heavenly ancient corpse burial ground like the palm of his hand. The group of Shigandang found this puzzling since Li Kai knew where these treasure earths were located so well, giving them a mysterious sensation, but they couldn't conveniently ask Li Kai. In fact, it was not surprising that Li Kai knew this burial ground so well. In the past millions of years, he, as the Dark Crow, had entered the heavenly ancient corpse burial ground more than anyone else, including even its deepest part where he even brought people in to attack the place where the Feng Shui treasure earths and dragon veins were located. How could he not be clear? On the way, Nan Huaren's group had met a few treasure trees and dan grass and even a few treasure mines, but they couldn't dig them because Li Kai warned them that this trip was only for trading. Outside of trading, they could not take anything else from the heavenly ancient corpse burial ground. This was an unchangeable law.